Hey, Lady Fish, 24th of April, 2018, and yeah, I'm just gonna have to do like these little news briefs or something because, you know, schedule and everything, but there's no shortage of stuff, again, just going through the news headlines. I see this one, to begin with. This Texas mom tried to burn her children in a car. She told the crowd to all come with her to heaven. Okay, three kids in her car tried to burn them alive. She even was pulling the hair of her kids to keep them in the car as it began to burn. Okay, now get this. Three daughters, ages 9, 11, and 13. Can't create that if even with your wildest imagination. But this is just another example of the spirit that is manifesting into this world with record speed. What you're looking at is nothing less than satanic influence rituals that, folks, if you're not in the blood of Christ, I'm telling you, this stuff is nothing to play around with. No lie. Notice how this week it's the young females that they're after to get ready for their big day of sacrifice. And she just happens to have three young girls in the car. Okay? I mean, this is happening, folks. This is all in the news. This is like just a few weeks old? Exorcisms on the rise. A number of people requesting help with demons. Triples. You think it's on the rise? I mean, even in the United States? Thriving, say experts. I mean, really, and who's administering most of these so-called exorcisms? It's the Catholic Church, right? I mean, a lot of good they are. I mean, even their own chief exorcist tells us the devil is in the Vatican. I mean, this is their own people, okay? Demand for exorcism are up threefold. So Vatican is holding a conference. Oh, that ought to fix everything. 11-11. I mean, it's just insane, people, but it's real. You need to understand this stuff is real. Without Christ, I'm telling you, it will ensnare you, and it ain't gonna be pleasant. So, yeah, on the same day, check this out. This was early this morning. A burned body found behind a dumpster in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Of all places. Oh, and it was at 7:29, 9:11. Look at the nice little C&I 3. And again, they dedicate about 2 lines to this literally burnt alive body. I mean, this is the stuff going on, people. You know, let's not forget about the old Toronto terror attack. Now this guy's getting pegged with 10 murder and 13 attempted murder. 13, of course, you know. All kinds of crazy things going on. Look at this over here, this church in San Francisco, the spiritual bastion, gets behind Beyonce Mass. This is all happening, folks. This is your new church, okay? That's your new church. And of course, I'll link all these, but, you know, Beyonce is hooked up with a PhD. Okay, well, she's a candidate at Vanderbilt, ooh, professor of Old Testament, okay, in the Hebrew Bible. So that makes her right and correct with all of her interpretations, of course. And she's just chummy buds with Beyonce and is actually doing some sort of lesson or class or something about Beyonce and the Hebrew Bible. Come on, folks. Beyonce and the Hebrew Bible. Really? That could be really interesting with Professor Yolanda. You know? Ooh, look at this. Obama's setting the tone for post-presidency, and he'll speak in South Africa on tolerance. The tolerance that has caused this world to be insane. Nonetheless, look at the image. This is the New York Times. And they choose this image with the fake interpreter and Mandela. And many of you know about the whole Mandela situation. And I'm telling you what, this is a spiritual war. And these people have a lot of weapons in their arsenal. You can't underestimate it. You can't. Okay? George Bush went in now after old Barb went on him. And now he is about to kick. But I got a sneaky feeling that this old goat ain't gonna die until he sees some of the fruit of his life's work. His New World Order's life's work play out in the real world. You know what I'm saying? So, definite heads up. Big giant demands on exorcisms. I don't even know if I already went over this stuff with you guys. Chief exorcist already saying that the devil is in the Vatican? Seriously? That's their own guy? And there was all kinds of more stuff that I wanted to show you that... Oh yeah, you know that there's a new kind of DNA now? Yeah, how convenient. Just how timely is that to have a new kind of DNA come out now? You can't make this up. And I'm telling you what, they are going to use this for some kind of deception, I assure you. Notice the little Y's there, upside down, reflecting each other. It's a mirror image, essentially. Unbelievable. And I'm telling you, this is what they're going to use this for. Manipulation. Big time. And of course, you know, we could go on, you guys, but I just want to share that with you. Before I do leave, though, I want to show you one thing that I've shown many times before. The chief exorcist says the devil's in the Vatican. Well, you don't know how right he is, because in the Vatican, right, this is the Sistine Chapel. And these are all the cardinals of the world and whatnot. And they are gathered in the Sistine Chapel to vote for the next pope. This is how they do it and where they do it. Okay? And they chose Pope Francis, right? Well, let's see Pope Francis with all his royalty cohorts and buddies here in the Sistine Chapel. And when that priest there said that the devil is in the Vatican? Well, he's exactly right, because there he is, right behind all the blue bloods. There's your dragon right there. See him? There's his eye, his nose right there. There's his mouth right there. It's the bottom of his chin. Let me back him up a little for you. Now you can see him. His eye, his nose, his mouth, the bottom of his chin right there. That is the dragon, people. Satan himself. Look at that. The Pope. Front and center. And that's Lucifer right there. Coming through the arch. Just like the Washington Arch for 9/11. This is all happening, folks. And it's going to play out. When this tripwire gets tripped, all hell's going to break loose. And you better be ready for it. That's all I can say. That's all I can say. And I pray that you are. And I pray that you know Jesus. And if you don't, that you seek him. Today. Tonight. Just ask him before you hit the sack. You know, Jesus, can you show me the truth? What is this all about? What is this crazy world that we're in? And what is the deal? I don't belong here. He'll show you. Just stick with it, okay? So you don't end up needing an exorcism. You know what I'm saying? So, I had to share all this stuff with you once again. I hope y'all are having a good week. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,